Hello, this is Fisnar USA. And this is a short video on how to do a programming routine on a desktop robot. Let's consider this robot in front of you, which is a small benchtop robot, our model F4200N. Right out of the box, the robot is programmable with a teach pendant. As you can see here, it comes standard as the basic programming tool for any robot that is received from us, from Fisnar. Now, programming a pattern, so let's say you are finished hooking it up. You have all the controls here to control the dispenser controller. You have the air, you have the power to it, and now you're ready to make the pattern. So let's say you have the pattern right over here. Okay. It's a simple pattern. You have a straight line going from here to here, and then it arcs up, and then goes to the right, and goes back down, and goes to the left, and then some three dots over there. Okay? Well, this is a basic tutorial on how to do this this routine, this pattern, and hopefully you will know how to do it by the end of this tutorial. Okay? So the main thing with all other robots, to program them, you have to go to position, and then you have to define that position. So let's say you want to go here and define this as a start of the line. With the 4000 series teach pendant, as you can see here, this is where the movement keys are. These are the movement keys. Now, for each teach pendant that we have for each series robot, the movement keys are located in different sections of the teach pendant. So for this particular one, the movement keys are here, but they are always present in every teach pendant we have for every series robot. So the first thing you need to do is locate where the movement keys are, and once you locate them, you will be able to move the robot head. Okay, so as you can see here, if you wanna just look here real quick, because the shaking's there. Okay, so as you can see, if I move the X, you will see the table move as well. Okay. Alright, and those are the movement keys. Now, there are three speeds to it. The first one is the slow, the second one is the medium, and the third one is the fast. In order to do that, there is a slow, which is press the movement key. That is a slow. You will see the X moving very, very slowly. So I'm not sure if you can see it during this video, but it will move slowly. All right. And if you go, and there's a medium speed wherein you press the movement key and the fast button in that order. And that is the medium speed. As you can see, the table moving. All right. And then there's the fast speed wherein you press the fast first before the movement key. Okay. And those are the three speeds. And that is helpful to know that you have three speeds available in order to locate the point precisely within the pattern. Okay? So this is a three-axis machine. As you can see, the movement keys has space for three axes. You have the X, the Y, and the Z properly labeled. If it's a four-axis, you will have a W plus and W minus, or an R plus or R minus, depending on the convention for the teach pendant. But for our sake, for our purposes, for this video, we will be focusing on the X, Y, and Z. All right? Okay, so as I've said before, in order to program the robot to a particular routine, you have to go to a position and then define that position. So let's say this is the screen of your teach pendant, you can see. Okay, first thing you want to do is move to a certain point. So, I'm going to change a program number to start a new program. Let's say I want to go to this point and make it as a line start. Okay, so what I do is move the table and move the head to go there. Now, in order to do that, I have to move the table this way. The table this way. I have to move the tip down, and I have to move the tip forward. Okay, so in order to do that, I have to move the Y forward. Okay, I have to move the X to the left, and I have to move the Z down. Okay, and then this is where the three movement speeds are helpful. So this way, you will not hit the tip towards the part. Okay, so let's say I'm there now. I am at the line start. I'm going to label that as a line start. In order to do that, I press enter. And you will come up with the F1 menu, or the point menu. The first thing that you should see there is a line start. Well, the second one is a line start. So you scroll down. Using the movement keys as arrow keys. Okay, as you can see, the asterisk there is the currently highlighted part. You press enter to select line start. So when you see the screen here, it automatically goes to the next line. But if you hit escape, you'll see that on the first line, you will see line start already programmed in there. And that is defined by that point that we moved into, and we define that as a line start. So that is the beginning on how to program the robot. Alright? Now for the views, on the teach panel you have two views. You have the list view, like what you see here, and if you press escape, this button, you have a detail view. And that's what it is. Now the detail view shows what the actual, what other parameters for that point are, the current location as well, as you can see there, and the current position of the point. So right now, the current position of the tip is the same as where we programmed it, because we didn't move it yet. So that's where it is. Okay, so that is for the line start. And then to scroll down the list, you have these two buttons here. Okay, and you can see it from here also, the address number. Okay, so for the screen, the address is the line address, which is we are now number 2. This is a program number, program number 28, and this is the current location of the tip. Okay, with respect to the robot drivers, okay? Alright, so we have started with the line start, and now we proceed with line passing. Okay, and the same way we do it, we press the movement keys. So right now, it's the same Y, it's the same height, the same Z. We only need to move the X this way, or the tip that way. So we're moving the X this way, to the left. And as you can see, the tip going into line passing. All right, once we get to position, we're gonna label that as a line passing. So we press enter, and we find line passing among the list. So we see line passing over there, number 3. We can scroll down. Okay, we're gonna scroll down and press enter. Okay, so if now it goes to the next position, which is address 3. Okay, so if we hit escape, we have a line start and a line passing. Okay, so let's say we want to verify the point that we saved. We can scroll up to that. Okay, you can see the caret there, the side view caret, the greater than symbol. So let's say we want to check where the line start is. We select that, you can see there, and then we press the move button, you can see here. Alright, so once we press that, the tip will go to where we saved the line start. Alright, and then when we go to line passing, it goes to line passing. So we scroll down using these buttons, and we press the move key to check where the position is actually located once you save the points. Alright, so that's it for the tutorial. You will need to do a line passing every time there's a change in position. So let's say you want a straight line from here to here. You only need to define the two endpoints, which is the line start and line passing in this case. The points in between are automatically calculated by the robot, and that provides us a straight line from point to point. The only reason we have a line passing here is because we're changing position. We're doing an arc on this next step, so that's why there is a line passing there. So you don't need to add a line passing in between the line if it's just a straight line. You just need to designate the start and end points, and then the robot automatically interpolates the points in between. Okay? So the next one is an arc. Okay? Because this is a teach pendant again. And the arc is useful for making a pattern that is circular. It doesn't have to be a perfect circle like this. It doesn't have to be oriented this way, which is mirror image on the X. It can be skewed to the right, to the left, to the Z. So it is very flexible. The only thing that you will need for an arc are two base points, which is in this case is a line passing, and the highest point of the arc, which is we will gonna label as an arc point. So as I've said again, it doesn't have to be a perfect arc or a perfect half circle like this. An arc can be an off arc, you know. So you can have an arc point here, and you can have a line passing at this point, and that will still make the arc as well. Okay, so we're gonna move again to that arc position. You see that I am moving the tip using the movement keys, and right now I am at the arc position, as you can see there. And the same thing, we press enter, the screen goes to point menu, this is F1 menu, and we find arc point, which is number 5, as you can see there. We'll go to number 5 and we press enter. Alright, so you can see we are on list view. You have 3 items there: line, start, line, passing, arc point. And that is how you program it. Now the rest is pretty straightforward. As I've said before, the arc needs a line passing at the end and at the beginning. So we will do another line passing here. And we're going to continue it with a rectangular pattern, line passing, and line end. As you can see, there is no break in between these two parts. You have from this direction to this direction, it's just a straight line. So we only need to define these 2 points at the end. And we have 3 dots as well. The same way of programming. You go into position and you label it as a dispense dot. Dispense dot is under the point menu also. If you press enter, dispense dot is number 1. Okay. Now with these parameters, with these functions, you have the line function and the arc. You can virtually do any pattern that you need to do, any combination of those. So these are the basic patterns. And once you get to know them, you will have a better understanding of how to do a very complicated pattern going forward. Okay? Alright, so I have already programmed this pattern, and I will show it to you. Okay? So let's say you're done with the programming and you want to test how you programmed it. So you can run it. Why not? Right? So we're gonna run it. Okay, as you can see, tip goes into position from point to point to point. Okay, and you can see that arc is doing exactly what it is programmed. We have defined it in 3 points: the start of the arc, the highest point of the arc, the end of the arc, and the rest is pretty straightforward. Change of position here from this line passing to this line end. Okay, and that is just a straight line, as you can see over there. And then you have the dispense points, 1, 2, and then 3. Okay, so pretty straightforward. I'm gonna turn the dispenser on and just dispense material just so you can see it. And here we go. Okay, as you can see, that is a blue material that we have. We are dispensing exactly as it is programmed. So making this pattern, we had 1, 2, 7 points to do the pattern. Of course, if you have a more complicated part, it will be a lot of points in between them. But that is the basic, and from these basic points and definition of points, you will be able to generate your own pattern as needed. Okay? Okay, and then we have dots. Alright, there you go, and this is the pattern. As you can see, this pattern is actually also in the manual, so you can practice with that. And once you get the hang of it, it should be pretty straightforward. So again, just a recap, in order to move the robot on the teach panel, there are movement keys, as you can see here. On the 4000 series robot, they're here. The basics of programming is you move to position and define it. In order to move it, you need the movement keys. Once you get the robot to position, you define the position, and that's where you go to the point menu. You press enter, and you go to the point menu, which is the F1 menu. And all of the points, the point definitions are in there. You have the dispense dot, line start, line passing, circle, arc point, line end, and any combination of those will give you a pattern as you need it. Okay. All right. So that ends the tutorial for making a dispense pattern using the robot. The next step would be to add the parameters like delays, timers, and all of that, or dummy points and all of that, to optimize the dispensed material. Okay? And that would be next in the tutorial. Hopefully this is helpful for you. This is Fisnar USA. Thanks.